Kotlin notebooks are pretty impressive. They're a great way to build a proof of concept in Kotlin, including the visualization code. And they have the full power of Timefold, our open source solver, at their disposal. So let's go ahead and optimize a planning problem, visualize the solution in HTML, and run some statistics on it. So here is the Timefold Notebooks repository, a new repository I've just created. And in there, you can find a Kotlin directory. And in the Kotlin directory, you can find our first Kotlin notebook, the school timetabling notebook. And I've gone ahead and downloaded this one and opened it up in IntelliJ. And in IntelliJ, I've specifically added the Kotlin notebook plugin so I can actually open this up, right? And when we do that, you can see here that we've opened up the, we get this Kotlin notebook editor. Now, in this particular notebook, we're going to solve the school timetabling problem. We're going to assign lessons to rooms and to time slots. So here we have a number of lessons like math, chemistry, French, and history. We have a number of rooms, room A and room B. We have a number of time slots, 8:30 and 9:30. And we need to assign each of these four lessons to one of those four rooms, or we'll get a result like this. Now, there's a number of constraints in there, hard and soft constraints. So for example, one of the hard constraints is we cannot, in one room, we can have at most one lesson at the same time. You can see if I can click on this. This is all written in Markdown and I can adjust this, but this is basically the hard constraints I was just talking about. And you can see there's a number of other hard and soft constraints in there. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to pull in the Timefold solver core dependency, and that will allow us to use Timefold later on. Now, we have a number of domain classes. The first thing is a data class for the room, which is just a string, like room A, room B, and room C. Then we have a time slot. A time slot is on a specific day of week, like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and at a specific start time and end time, like for example, from 8:30 to 9:30. You can see we use java.time in here, but you could use the kotlin.xDateTime too, right? Then we have our lesson, which is those math and chemistry and so forth that we need to assign to these rooms and these time slots. So you can see these have a subject, have a teacher and a student group, subject like math, chemistry and so forth, a teacher like Marie Curie, and a student group like 9th grade. And they also have an ID, and we'll use that later to distinguish different lessons for the same subject and the same teacher for the same student group from each other. And we need to assign these to time slots. So they have a time slot and a room. And you can see these start out as null, and the Timefold solver will assign them to actually a time slot and a room for each of those, taking into account all of the other lessons. So Timefold needs to know it can change those. So those are planning variables. And of course, the class that contains those, that's a planning entity class. Let's take a look at the constraints. So we have six constraints in here defined. We have a room conflict constraints that I talked about earlier. So let's take a look at this particular constraint. Three hard constraints, three soft constraints, as you can see. And this room conflict constraint, here we're saying, okay, select me any unique pair of lessons. So two lessons. And then if they are have the same time slots and they have the same room, so if they actually happen in the same place at the same time, then we have a problem. So then we're going to penalize that with the hard constraint. So we're going to basically say, Timefold solver, please don't do this. Don't put two lessons in the same room at the same time. And you can see that is then the room conflict constraint. Similarly, we have a bunch of other constraints. And when we run it, you'll see what happens when we start adding and removing these. So then we have the data class, the Timefold timetable class. So the timetable class just has a list of all of the time slots, rooms, and lessons. This is pretty much boilerplate. This is, you can copy this from any other Timefold example, and you'll see this doesn't change much, so I'm not going to go deeply into this one. And of course, we want to create some test data to try all of this out. You could read this from a JSON file. I've now just gone ahead and just generated directly in Kotlin. And you can see that here we generate 10 time slots, two different days, and three rooms, and then 20 lessons, right? Like, for example, chemistry from Marie Curie. So now we need to solve it. How do you solve it? So what we're going to do is we're going to create a solver factory based upon these classes. We need to tell Timefold, okay, this is my data class, this is my entity class, these are my this is my constraints. We're going to tell them to solve for 5 seconds. So 5 seconds, that's long how long you can solve. We're going to generate the timetable with the code we showed earlier, and then we're going to build a solver and solve it. So this is the big thing to do, solver.solve. You give it the problem, it gives you the solution. Okay, you see I ran it here before, but let's just run that again and see how that works. So you can see it's running right now. It's actually already solving the problem, as you can see. There's no solution yet. But if you wait a bit longer, you can see the solution just popped up. And we have a score of 10 soft. And you might wonder, what is that score? So we'll visualize that in a minute. But first, let's actually visualize the solution. How do we visualize the solution? Well, here's the code, the Kotlin code to actually visualize the solution. So the nice thing about these notebooks is that you can write your visualization code in Kotlin. You're not writing it in some other language like Lava, JavaScript, or TypeScript, which means that you can also use the construct that Timefold gives you out of the box. So you can, for example, on a solution, you can get the score, right? But on that score, that's actually of type score, you can actually ask things like, I actually want just the short score, so I can do to short string. And you can use those APIs directly in here. And I'll rerun that in a second and we'll see the results of that. So what I do here is I create a table where I iterate over across all of the rooms and I just print out their name and then I do the similar things. And then you can see I even do lookups here into a map to figure out, okay, on this particular cell of that table, is there actually one or more lessons that are assigned in this room and at that time? And when we do that, we actually generate this code. So this is the result. Now, like I said, I've used the to short string. So the to short string will take the score and will actually cut out the parts that are zero. So if I rerun this, and you can just rerun a single cell without rerunning the whole thing again by with this button. So let's do that. Can see that, boom, I made a mistake. So that's good, right? It is not sure that this is non-null, this is Kotlin. So I'm going to now fix that and rerun that again. Here we go. And you can see now that the score is actually written in a simpler way. It's just 11 soft and the zero hard part is actually gone. Now, next thing is we can actually analyze the score. So what we do is we create a solution manager. And on the solution manager, we ask it, here, please analyze my solution and give me, break down the solution and tell me, okay, what are constraints are in there and how heavy are those? And again, with some rendering code, we visualize that. And here, as you can see, I visualized it and the score is zero hard, 11 soft still. But you can see we break that down and it says those 11 soft are actually all coming from a single constraint, the teacher time efficiency constraint. There's a constraint that makes sure when you have two lessons for the same teacher that are back to back, that we get some points. We get actually get a reward. And as you can see, 11 times Timefold Solver was able to do that. I can even go further and break those down to figure out which particular teachers are involved or, you know, get those good benefits. But that's out of scope today. Now, the next thing you want to do is you actually want to visualize some statistics around this, especially when you have a very big data set. Visualizing the solution like this, we will not be able to see the forest through the trees, right? So what we do is, what's a great library there is Kandy. So with the Kandy library, let me just show you. So I'm going to switch. I've actually opened this notebook in DataLore, which is an online cloud platform to run these notebooks, and I've run the same notebook, right? Again, with the run all button, except that I've added some code to play with Kandy. Kandy also works locally, but on this particular machine, I had some issues, so I went ahead and ran it in DataLore. So what I've done here, I've used Kandy 0.5, and I've created a graph, and you can see the graph here, which shows how many lessons each teacher has per weekday. So you can see, for example, in this result, that Penelope Cruz has 4 hours of lessons, four lessons, and on Tuesday, and zero on Monday. Then Diana Jones also has four on Tuesday, and so forth. And you can see only Marie Curie is actually having lessons on two separate weekdays. And this really gives some insight into the data set. And you can imagine if you're doing a big data set with a lot of teachers and a lot of days, you can clearly see which of the teachers have a really fractional schedule and which do not, right? And the way I've done this, if I've just said, okay, I've created a data set for Kandy and I've plotted that and said, okay, I want horizontal bars, I want to have a stack, and I want to have the colors in hue, of course, because those are prettier than the normal colors. Next time you need to build a proof of concept to optimize a planning problem, why not give Kotlin Notebooks and Timefold a try? You can find a link to our notebooks in the description below.